Welcome friends to a new session on micro teaching. This session will enable you to understand the concept and to apply it. Micro teaching, a skill based practice. Relevance of micro teaching. The real importance of micro teaching emerges from the problems student teachers have while trying to develop their skills in teaching. Getting in front of school students is a demanding experience for a budding teacher. Beginning teachers earnestly try to prepare themselves. For this, novice teachers may read books on teaching methods, attend lectures, and take courses on teaching. In theory, everything seems much simple, though the complexity of real teaching circumstances is overwhelming. While talking about good teaching is easily done, practicing it to mastery is lived out. Instruction to student teachers in desirable teaching activities is too vague and general. An effective model, example, or exemplar of good teaching is not easily available. To become effective teachers, beginning teachers need knowledge of subject, communication skills, management ability, and commitment. Thus, it is clear that the job of beginning teachers is not simple. Then, what can be done for solving these problems of beginning teachers? Actual teaching situation requires being scaled down. Multiple aspects of the teaching require to be specially attended to. Student teachers require opportunities to practice every teaching activity separately but meaningfully as far as possible. The skills learned separately needs to be further integrated such that what is learned in simple conditions are transferable to complex classroom scenarios. Micro teaching is a technique of teacher training where these requirements are met. Micro teaching is a technique of skill training. It was developed in the United States in response to the weaknesses of the traditional model of teacher education in 1960s. Then there were general disaffection about the public with people performance in schools. Schools in America were held accountable by the public for their people's performance. It was in this context that micro-teaching was firstly introduced in 1963 at Stanford University by Dwight Allen and Ryan as an innovative method of teaching practice. Originally, Allen and his colleagues had their focus on verbal and non-verbal aspects of teachers' speech and general performance. At that time, it was a revolutionary program of teaching skills. This innovative model was first applied to teaching science and applied later on to training language teachers too. Micro-teaching is a technique that allows beginning teachers to practice and master teaching skills. It reduces the complexity of teaching situation. Micro-teaching helps to train prospective teachers in specific teaching skills. Practice of simpler teaching behaviors is in small group settings. The practice setting in ideal situation is aided by video recordings. Micro-teaching is an exceptional method to develop skills and confidence of beginning teachers. It does this by demonstrating a variety of teaching techniques and then allowing student teachers to practice those techniques supported with helpful feedback. With initiative from National Council of Educational Research and Training and early studies of B.K. Passy, referred to as father of micro-teaching in India, micro-teaching is used with great emphasis in the teacher training programs in India from late 1970s. Micro-teaching definition and functions. Definitions of micro-teaching will help us clarify the meaning of micro-teaching. These definitions will help us in recognizing the important features of micro-teaching as well. Hence, let us have some definitions of micro-teaching. Micro-teaching is the scaled-down teaching encounter in a class size and class time. Allen, D.W. in 1966. Micro-teaching is a training concept that can be applied at various pre-service and in-service stages in the professional development of teachers. Allen D.W. and Ryan K.A. 1969. Oliveiro who was one of the original co-workers of Allen and Ryan at Stanford, defined micro-teaching as follows. Micro-teaching is a scaled-down sample of actual teaching which generally lasts 10 to 30 minutes and involves 4 to 10 students. A micro-teaching session stimulates a regular classroom instructional period in every way except that both time and number of students are reduced. Olivero further explained that micro-teaching is scaled down in terms of time and number of students. The lesson is scaled down to reduce some of the complexities of teaching act, thus allowing the teacher to focus on selected aspects of teaching. The following definition gives more stress on the training dimension of micro-teaching. It goes that micro-teaching is a method for training teachers where explicit use is made of the principle of feedback and where the teacher learning situation remains limited with respect to the number of students to whom the lesson is given, the duration of the lesson, the extent of the lesson in terms of contents and didactic presentation. Kiewit, 1972. Another well-known definition in India by Pasi BK and Lalitha MS, given in 1976, is micro-teaching is a training technique which requires student teachers to teach a single concept using specified teaching skill to a small number of pupils in a short duration of time. Micro-teaching is defined as a laboratory-based skill training technique which simplifies the complexity of teaching for practical purposes. It is a scaled down but normal teaching. Complexity of actual teaching in terms of time, number of pupils and skills involved are scaled down. Reducing the complexity makes it easier for student teachers to practice and acquire specified skills of teaching. This enables intensive laboratory experience accompanied by controlled supervision and immediate feedback. Let us have the characteristics of micro-teaching in the words of the originators of the idea. According to Allen and Ryan, 1969, micro-teaching has the following characteristics. It is a real teaching situation. It reduces the complexity of real classroom teaching situation in terms of the number of students, the amount of time and the amount of learning contents. It emphasizes training for mastery of teaching activities such as skills, techniques, methods and curriculum selection. It offers better control over practicing teaching activities because many factors easily can be manipulated to attain this greater degree of control in the training program. The feedback dimension is expanded considerably because the student can receive meaningful feedback immediately after the performance and with the help of a variety of technological teaching media. During micro-teaching sessions, observation and interaction analysis instruments also assist in improving the student-teacher's performance by providing precise and objective feedback. Yes, micro-teaching is an instrument for teacher training. It offers the student teachers the opportunity to practice teaching activities under controlled and simulated circumstances as in a laboratory. The controlled environment allows the complexity of the real teaching situation is simplified in terms of the number of students, the amount of teaching time, the amount of teaching activities to which particular attention can be given. Principles of micro-teaching. The very name of micro-teaching implies that it is a microscopic, small version of teaching in comparison to the usual process of teaching. Micro-teaching as a teacher training technique in a simplified context requires the teacher trainee to teach a single concept of content only that allows teaching within 5 to 10 minutes using only one specified teaching skill for a short time than usual classroom duration, 5 to 10 minutes rather than a whole period, to a very small number of pupils than a regular class, in most cases 5 to 8 of your peers or 5 to 10 pupils. The first principle of this technique is the micro element in terms of class time, scope of content and time frame. Let us elaborate this principle of micro teaching as a reduced situation further. Limitation of number of students. The number of students in a micro teaching situation or the number of persons to whom the micro lesson is presented is approximately 5. The reasons are: this makes the condition less threatening to the student teacher. This number of peers students is easy to manage. This keeps classroom discipline problems to the least. The student can first gain self-confidence in using the particular teaching skill before he is confronted with the management of large number of pupils. Certain teaching skills like individualization can be practiced more effectively with this limited number of students. Limitation of the amount of teaching time. The lesson plan of a micro teaching session is referred to as a micro lesson. The teaching time in a micro lesson is limited to between 5 and 10 minutes. The reasons mentioned by the developers of the technique are the following. This time is sufficient for effectively practicing most teaching skills. Shorter duration holds boredom to a minimum of both student teachers and pupils. It gives opportunity for all student teachers in a batch to effectively practice teaching skills within reasonable period. Recording, observing, analyzing, and evaluating the lessons of longer than 10 minutes provides no additional information. Limitation of the number of teaching skills. The number of teaching skills practiced during a micro teaching situation is limited to only 1. Therefore, the select teaching skill becomes the focal point of attention of all student teachers, of both practitioner and the observer. This helps student teachers to acquire better insight into the functioning of the teaching skill of concern. The influence of other teaching skills is eliminated to possible extent. Limitation of the amount of learning content. The micro lesson essentially has limited aims regarding the contents. Learning a large amount of content is purposefully avoided. Instead, the teaching skill being practiced gets the attention it ought to receive during the practice of skills. Therefore, more attention can be directed to the teaching skill during the teaching encounter. The student teacher has better opportunity to systematically analyze and reduce the limited learning content. Thorough analysis of content adds to effective designing and preparation of micro lesson. There are other aspects to micro teaching too. The original form of micro teaching insisted on actual students as an authentic audience, but later models allow student teachers as the participants. Where all the participants of a micro teaching session are student teachers, the participants may be from various disciplines and may not be familiar with your content. However, small the content is, a micro teaching session should be a complete instructional segment. Each session of micro teaching should deal with topics that will provide new learning for the other participants. The instructor should not ask the participants to play imaginary roles. Micro teaching cycle. There are 3 broad phases for practicing micro teaching. They are knowledge acquisition phase, skill acquisition phase, transfer phase of micro teaching. The major elements of these 3 phases are the following. Knowledge acquisition has the following tasks. 1. Student teachers learn about the skill and its components through discussion and illustrations. 2. They learn the purpose of the skill and the condition under which it proves useful. 3. Demonstration of the skill by the expert. 4. Examining the component behaviors involved in the skill to clarify its characteristics. In skill acquisition phase, student teachers undergo the following: 1. Planning the micro lesson. 2. Self-practice the skill demonstrated by their supervisor. 3. Performs the teaching skill through the micro teaching cycle. 4. Continues efforts till one attains mastery level. 5. Feedback about the mastery level acquisition of the skill is received. 6. The feedback facilitates change in behavior of the student teacher in the desired direction. Transfer phase of micro teaching comes after attaining mastery and command over the teaching skills. In this phase, 1. Selection of the topic and related content of such a nature in which the use of components of the skill under practice. 2. Topic is analyzed into different activities of the teacher and the pupils. 3. Planning of the link lesson in logical sequence to facilitate maximal application of the components of a skill. 4. Student teachers integrates all the skills by linking them one another through link lessons. 5. Transfer to actual classroom teaching is done. The original Stanford model of micro teaching developed by Allen et al. Consisted of the steps namely teach, review and reflect and reteach. Later on, many practitioners have brought modification to the original model. However, all the micro teaching sessions have the following steps. These steps are repeated in cyclic way and hence micro teaching sessions are referred to as micro teaching cycles. Teach session involves attempts by student teacher to practice the components of the skill in suitable situations as per the planning. Student teacher is free and bound to bring necessary variation from the plan if the micro classroom situation demands such flexibility. Courage and self-confidence to handle the situation arising in the class effectively is part of this learning process. Review feedback session provides information to the student teacher's performance. Feedback on the teach session includes strengths and weaknesses relating to the performance. This helps the recipient to improve upon the performance in the desired direction. Replanning of the lesson is to incorporate the points of strength and removing the points not skillfully handled during the teaching session. Replanned lesson can be on the same topic or can be on another topic. Reteaching of the replanned lesson can be to the same group or to a different group. If the topic of the replanned lesson is the same, another group is employed to eliminate boredom or monotony of the people. Reteaching adds to the courage and confidence to perform better than the previous attempt. Refeedback is as important as the original feedback, and this stage adds to the strength of micro-teaching to really modify the student-teacher's skill for the better. Steps of micro-teaching. The above account of the micro-teaching in three phases can be summarized as the following steps. Step 1. Explaining the purpose and components of the select skill to the student-teachers with suitable examples. Step 2. Demonstration of the skill by the teacher educator in simulated condition to the student teachers. Step 3. Planning of the micro lesson by student teacher for practice on the basis of demonstration. Step 4. Teaching the micro lesson to the micro class under the supervision of teacher educator with recording facilities on and peers as observers. Step 5. Receiving the feedback on the basis of the observation from the supervisor, peers, and by observing the recordings, if any. Feedback reinforces the instances of effective use of the skill and suggests ways to correct the weaknesses. Step 6. Replanning for another micro session on the same skill based on the feedback. Step 7. Reteaching on the basis of the replanned lesson. Step 8. Receiving re-feedback to further refine beyond the first feedback. Step 9. Repeating the teach-reteach on the same skill till mastery of the skill is achieved. Advantages and disadvantages of micro-teaching. As a tool for teacher preparation, micro-teaching trains teaching behaviors and skills in small group settings, aided by video recordings. In a protected environment of friends and colleagues, teachers can try out a short piece of what they usually do with their students and receive a well-intended collegial feedback. A micro-teaching session is a chance to adopt new teaching and learning strategies and through assuming the student role to get an insight into students' needs and expectations. It is a good time to learn from others and enrich ensemble repertoire of teaching methods. A micro-teaching session is much more comfortable than real classroom situations because it eliminates pressure resulting from the length of the session, the scope and the content of the matter to be conveyed, and the need to face large number of students, some of whom may be inattentive or even hostile. Another advantage of micro-teaching is that it provides skilled supervisors who can give support, lead the session in a proper direction, and share some insights from the pedagogic sciences. Micro-teaching manifests itself as a reduced situation, a training and practice situation for essential teaching skills until they are mastered before the more complex real teaching situation is faced. A simulated situation with a micro lesson in a short time. Friendly feedback from supportive teachers and peers for developing one skill. Changes brought in student teachers to grasp teaching as a complex, challenging profession. Effective way of creating greater interest in and enthusiasm for teaching. A way of building up student teachers' self-confidence as teachers and informed concern among future teachers for improving and evaluating on teaching. One of the major criticisms of micro-teaching as a skill training technique is that student teachers may not be able to transfer the skills learned in micro-classes to normal classroom teaching because of the latter's complexity. As observed before, micro-teaching is the technique developed to teach essential technical skills in teaching. The major criticism against the technical skill of teaching is that the practice ignores the conceptual theoretical decision-making of teacher. Its critics are of the opinion that micro-teaching dehumanizes the teacher while reducing teaching learning tasks to a mechanical prescriptive process. Critics observe that teachers teach with more than observable behavioral skills. Although extremely valuable, it is clear that micro-teaching is only one of the many modes of training that can be applied. One must guard against an oversimplification of the skill aspect of micro-teaching. This can become the whole image of the interactive event and the human or personal dimension can become lost. Therefore, micro-teaching needs to be viewed as an integral part of a total teacher education program and it should always function within this context. Some other criticisms against micro-teaching are as follows. A large number of trainees cannot be given the opportunity for reteaching and replanning. It is very time-consuming technique. It requires special classroom setting. It covers only a few specific skills. It deviates from normal classroom teaching. Now, let us summarize this session. Micro-teaching is a skill training technique applied in teacher education. In practice, a skill is identified for focusing and practice, and then written information explaining the skill are provided for the student teachers to study beyond the verbal description. This is followed by a demonstration of the skill, that is modeling, on videotape or by live model. After this, the student teacher prepares a short micro lesson plan for about 5 minutes based on the skill to be practiced. the lesson is executed and may be recorded on audio tape or video tape. Feedback by the supervisors and peers and based on played back recordings helps the teacher to prepare improved lesson plan. The procedure of micro teaching involves cyclic steps of plan, teach, feedback, replan, reteach and refeedback. These steps are repeated till the people teacher attains mastery in the use of the skill. Micro teaching uses a single skill on one concept of content for teaching with a class of 5 to 10 pupils for practice in 5 to 10 minutes. After the acquisition of all the core skills, it is possible to integrate them for effective teaching in actual classroom situations. Now, you try to do the following task. Identify major technical skills of teaching. Select the most essential skills of micro teaching skills and prepare micro lessons for practicing them one by one with assistance from your supervising teacher and peers. Now, here are some books for your further study. 1. Micro Teaching A Description by Alan D. W. et al. 1969 from Stanford University Press. 2. Micro Teaching As a Vehicle of Teacher Training, Its Advantages and Disadvantages by Ananda Krishnan N. in 1993. Core Teaching Skills A Micro Teaching Approach by Jangira N. K. and Singh A. 1982, published by NCRT New Delhi. Becoming Better Teachers by Pasi B. K. in 1976 from Center for Advanced Study in Education, MS University of Baroda. You may further use the following online resource as well. www.ibe.unesco.org. Thank you for watching this session. See you in the next session. Until then, goodbye.